Hello and welcome back. I promised a little more complexity for today and you'll have it. We are putting loops inside of other loops and I'll explain why that is a good idea and what amazing things you can do with it. Don't worry, we'll go through it very slowly and I'm sure you'll handle it in no time. We'll also challenge you with a few little exercises and thought puzzles, so I hope you'll have fun. Here we go. I will once again start with a practical example. Let's do multiplication tables. I will start with a simple multiplication table of 3. So I will want to show the multiplication of 1 times 3, 2 times 3, 3 times 3, and so on until 10 times 3. And my multiplier starts at 1. And here I will create a loop while my multiplier is smaller than 10. I will print my multiplier, of course converted to string, plus multiplied by 3 equals, and then the result, which would be my multiplier multiplied by 3. And of course this also needs to be converted to a string. This should be something you're familiar with by now. Now remember that in a while loop I always need to change the control variable, in my case my multiplier, and I'm adding 1 to it, so my new multiplier is going to be my old multiplier plus 1, so that it actually goes up every time. And I can see here when I run this, I made a mistake because it only goes up to 9 times 3. So obviously this line while multiplier is smaller than 10 needs to be while my multiplier is smaller than or equal to 10, so that I also get the 10 multiplier. And when I run this, I can see that now it is all correct. So I'm happy now, except for the fact that I chose the 3 multiplication table. And I actually want to produce all the multiplication tables from 1 to 10. And I can do that by defining another variable here. This one is called multiplication table. And I will set it to 1 because I want to start with the multiplication table of 1. And I'm going to put my loop into another loop. So I want to run this other loop for every multiplication table. I have to indent everything that goes into this loop, so you can see that the third line of the loop is indented twice because it is inside the second loop. And the second loop is inside the first loop, that's why it is indented as well. So with this, I can actually change this line, and instead of the static 3, I can put my variable here, which is multiplication table, from here. And of course, this also needs to be converted to a string. And then after the second loop is done, I will increase the multiplication table by 1. Remember, the control variable always has to change, otherwise I'm stuck in an infinite loop. I will also reset the multiplier variable to 1. Because in the second loop, the multiplier variable went all the way up to 10, so it is 10 now when the loop finishes, and I need to reset it to 1 so that with the next multiplication table, it starts at the beginning again. Now I can run everything, and you will see that I will get all the multiplication tables from 1 to 10. In summary, we learned that loops can be inside of other loops, and this helps you create some pretty complex situations. Theoretically, a loop can be inside 2 other loops or 3 other loops or even more, but that will get really complicated. So be a little careful with that. Having a loop inside another loop is very common though. You always need it if you want to, for example, put a table on the screen and you generate the content of the first cell, then move to the second column, then move to the third column, and so on, Then go to the second row and do the same thing over again.
All right, that was all for today. Next time, we will take a look at another variable again. This one is called a list. See you then.